Friends, we know that potentiometer is a device with the help of which we can measure potential difference accurately. Because there is no any current drawn, we can measure accurate potential difference. There are certain uses of potentiometer. Out of this application, first one is to compare EMF of two cells. We can compare EMF of two cells either by individual cell method or by Sermon difference method. Another use of potentiometer is to determine internal resistance of a cell. First, let us discuss to compare EMF of two cells. Suppose any two cells given to you, that time EMF of that cells can be compared by using a potentiometer. First, let me draw a potentiometer. There is nothing but a wooden plate on which several meter long wire, uniform conducting wire, it is mounted. Suppose a 4 meter long wire, it is mounted over that wooden plate. 4 meter wire, it is in a segment form, first segment of 100 centimeter. Then here are nothing but conducting strips. Again 100 centimeter segment. Then conducting strip, again 100 centimeter segment, conducting strips, and 100 centimeter segment. Here is uniform wire, conducting wire. This wire, let me call this wire AB wire. This point is A point and this point is B point. AB is uniform conducting wire of having cross-section area A, potential gradient if capital A is the length of wire AB, then the potential gradient for this wire AB, A is equal to BAB by A is a constant. Now, one source of electricity is connected such that A point is at higher potential and B point is at lower potential. Battery of EMF P, here is a key, and rheostat, they are always connected in a series. Variable terminal of rheostat is given to the B point of wire. Now, this is potentiometer. Actually, potentiometer is nothing but the simplest several meter long wire which is mounted over a wooden plate. And through that wire, you have to pass certain current for the same purpose. There is a source of electricity is connected. And we know that if there is a source, then key and rheostat, they are always connected in a series. When we put up the key, that time there is a flow of current. Use of rheostat is to control current in the circuit. Now, our aim is to compare EMF of two cells. Suppose two cells given to you. Out of this first cell, let me draw here first cell of EMF E1, and suppose another cell is connected here of EMF E2. Here is a key, here is also one key is connected, and both keys, they are given to the galvanometer. Another terminal of galvanometer is given to the sliding key or jockey. Let me call this key K1, and here is the K2. This is the simplest circuit arrangement for the comparison of EMFs of two given cells. Suppose two cells given to you of EMF E1 and E2, we have to compare this EMF by using potentiometer. Positive of a cell, they given to the point A. Keep in mind that This A point should always be connected to the positive potential of the source of electricity. That means if the A point is at higher potential as compared to the B point, and to the point A, positive of these cells, they are connected. Now, at very first, kept K2 open and K1 closed. That means for this individual cell method, first we have to connect only P1 in the circuit. In this circuit, at very first we have to connect only first cell. If K2 is open, then the current will be flowing through this E1. This galvanometer shows certain deflection and we have to measure certain reading. Now when we pass here certain current, then by touching this jockey in between points A and B, we have to obtain null point. Now, at very first, sense certain current by keeping this key closed, this K2 open, K1 closed. If only even in the circuit, that time touch this jockey at the point A and also the point B. If galvanometer shows a reverse deflection at the point A and B, we say that our circuit connections are correct. Now, slide this jockey along this wire AB such that null point is obtained. Suppose D null point is obtained here. Along this wire, now touch this jockey to each and every point of this wire and find out null point. If null point is obtained here at point D, then measure this length between A and D point. Suppose this length is L1. We can measure this length with the help of a scale mounted below this wire. Now, if this length between point A and D is L1, then according to the principle of a potentiometer, what is principle? Potential difference between point A and D is directly proportional to length between that two points, according to principle of potentiometer. Potential difference between point A and D is directly proportional to length between that point. Now, when this EMF is connected in a circuit, then the potential difference, here we get the null point. At the point D, we get the null point. But to determine this potential difference, this potential difference is exactly equal to EMF E1. This EMF E1, when we send certain current through this wire, it is observed that this potential difference between AD point, it is exactly equal to EMF E1. And therefore, this E1 written as E1 is equal to, directly proportional with this sign, can be written as the potential gradient into L1. Now, for the another measurement, kept K1 open and K2 closed. If K2 is closed, means E2 is in the circuit, while E1 is disconnected. That time, current will be flowing through this E2. When we send certain current, then once again, touch this jockey to each and every point along this wire AB and find out the null point. If we get that null point is here, suppose D point is obtained here, then measure this length AD. Suppose that length is L2. It can be measured with the help of scale. It is observed that when we get the null point, that means galvanometer shows zero deflection. That means there is no any current through the galvanometer. That means this potential difference E2 is exactly equal to potential difference between AD. And therefore, According to the principle of potential meter, E2 is directly proportional to L2, and it can be written as E2 is equal to potential gradient into L. Now divide this first equation by second, then we get E1 upon E2 is equal to L1 upon L2. In this way, we can compare EMF of two given cells by using potentiometer. If out of these two EMF, if one is unknown, that time unknown EMF can be determined by using the same formula for this individual cell method. Now, for the comparison of EMF, there is another method, and that method is nothing but sum and difference method. Let me discuss sum and difference method. Here is the individual cell method in which these cells are connected individually, separately. But here, we have to connect both cells at a time, either in a sum form or in a difference form, either in a assist form or in a opposite form. That means here we have to connect both cells at a time, either by this manner. It is called as a sum manner. Negative of a first is connected to positive of a next cell. We say that both the cells are in a sum form or in a assist form. And for the difference form, we have to connect negative of first connected to negative of next. Means negative, negative, common. Or the positive, positive, common. But here we take negative, negative, common. Here is a cell E1. Here is a E2, here is a point A, here is galvanometer, here is a point A, here is a galvanometer. Now, for the same purpose, let me draw once again the diagram. Potential meter is drawn. We know that several meter long wire, practically 4 meter long wire, which is mounted over a wooden board. This wire is uniform conducting wire of having potential gradient A constant VV by L if A is the length of wire. And if a source of electricity is connected such that A point is at higher potential compared to the B point, that means positive of a cell is connected to the A point. If the source of electricity having EMF E, this is EK, and gives that variable terminal of both cells same. Variable terminal of those cells connected to the point B. This is simplest potential meter. Now, we have to connect E1 and E2 directly at a time. Therefore, here is the arrangement of first cell here and then reversing key, four-way key. E has four terminals. Out of this, here E2 cell is connecting such that positive of E2 is connected to this terminal, negative of a cell is given to this terminal, and this galvanometer is connected here, and the another terminal of galvanometer is given to the sliding key. This is reversing key. We say that four-way key. This cell of having EMF E1, this cell of having EMF E2. By using this four-way key, we can connect both cells at a time. If negative of first cell connected to the positive of E2, here negative of a first cell is connected to the positive of a second, that time both cells are in some manner. And when negative of first is connected to negative of second, look at the diagram. Negative of a first is connected to this negative. Then we say both cells are in opposite manner. This diagram is for opposed manner or the difference manner. Are in some manner, that time potential difference is E1 plus E2, and when both cells are in opposite manner, that time potential difference will be E1 minus E2. Now, send certain current through this wire by keeping it closed, and if E1 and E2 they are connected in some manner, that means negative of E1 is connected to positive of E2, then we say this circuit is in some manner. And then slide this jockey along this wire AB so as to find out null point, so as to obtain D point. This D point is nothing but null point. That time galvanometer shows zero deflection. Measure this length AD. Suppose this length is L1, then according to the principle of potentiometer, potential difference between AD, it is equal to potential difference between these two points, and this potential difference is E1 plus E2, because both cells they are connected in a some manner, and that's why we say that E1 plus E2 is equal to K into L1. Now, reverse this key such that both cells are in difference manner, means in opposed manner. Negative of first cell is connected to negative of next cell. Then, we say the circuit is in opposed manner, in a difference manner. Then once again slide this jockey along this wire so as to obtain null point. Suppose we get null point here. Then measure this length. Suppose this length is L2. It is observed that we get this L2 length when the potential difference is E1 minus E2. We have to take precaution that E1 should always be greater than E2. That time potential difference between A and D dash point is equal to potential difference between these two terminals, and that potential is E1 minus E2. We can write according to the principle of potentiometer, it is written as E1 minus E2 is equal to K into L2. Now, dividing both this equation, we get E1 plus E2 upon E1 minus E2 is equal to L1 bar LP. By using this formula, we can compare EMF, or it can be written as E1 upon E2 is equal to L1 plus L2 upon L1 minus L2. By using this formula, we can compare EMF of two given cells by using sum and difference method. Here, comparison of EMF by using individual cell method. This is the application of potentiometer to compare EMF of two given cells, either by individual cell method or sum and difference method. Friends, use of potentiometer is to compare EMF of two given cells, and another use is to determine internal resistance of a cell. Now, Let me draw potential meter. We know that potential meter is nothing but several meter long wire which is mounted over a wooden plate. Here is 4 meter long wire, AB wire, which is mounted over wooden plate. Now, same certain current with the help of source of electricity, that means battery is connected. Battery of EMF E. Here is a key K and the rheostat. They are always connected in a series. Variable terminal of rheostat is given to the point V. Let me draw V. Now, one cell is connected here. Of having certain internal resistance, R internal resistance, this cell having EMF E1, and one resistance box is connected. Resistance box in which various resistances are there. First, here is one key is connected, then resistance box is connected. One terminal of galvanometer is connected to this resistance box and another terminal of galvanometer is given to the sliding key. This is the simplest circuit arrangement for the determination of internal resistance. Here is the cell of heavy EMF E1. And it has internal resistance. We know that the source of electricity, any battery having internal resistance because it is made up of certain electrolytes, certain chemicals are there. And because of which it has certain internal resistance. Now, how to determine the internal resistance? Here is the extra arrangement of resistance box of resistance R and here is the key. Let me call K1. At very first, kept this K1 open. Means, in this circuit, only E1 is connected. This R is absent. That time, find out the null point D. By sliding this dot here along this wire, find out null point D. At which this galvanometer shows zero deflection. Now, measure this length. Suppose this length is L1. With the help of scale, we can measure this length L1. Now, at very first, we kept key closed, same certain current. Then, this K1 is open, that means R box is not in the circuit. R is disconnected. Only same E1 is in circuit. That time, slide this jockey along this wire AB. Find out the null point D. If D point is obtained at a distance L1 from the point A, that time, according to the principle of a potential meter, we say that potential difference E1 is equal to potential gradient. We know that potential gradient is equal to VAB upon L. If capital A is the length of wire AB, VAB is the potential difference between point AB. Then K is the potential gradient. Then E1 is equal to K into L1. Now, this K1 is closed. Now, if K1 closed means this R box is also in the circuit, then remove certain R from this resistance box means we have to connect here certain resistance R in the circuit. Here one loop is obtained. We call that P, Q, Q, S, T loop. Now, here certain current will be flowing. Here is one small loop P, Q, STPU. Now, when we apply certain resistance here, then once again slide this jockey along this wire AB and find out another null point. If that null point is obtained here, suppose null point, it will be obtained here, then measure this length. Suppose this length is L2. That time, potential difference for this terminal, it is equal to, suppose V. V is the potential difference between this terminal. Then same potential difference is here between point A and D. And according to the principle of potentiometer, this potential, it is equal to potential gradient into L2. We know that potential difference between any two points is directly proportional to length between that two points. According to this principle, we can say that potential difference between point A, it is equal to V, is equal to A into L2. Now, dividing equation first by second. Let me call this equation first. Here is the equation second. Dividing equation. We get E1 upon V is equal to L1 upon L2. Now, consider this loop PQSTP. Consider loop PQSTP. E1, it can be written as, for this E1, we have to take this internal resistance and this external resistance, that means IR plus IR. And for this potential difference, we have to take V is equal to I into R. Substituting these values in the above equation, equation number 3, we get this equation written as IR plus IR upon IR is equal to L1 by L2. Here is I common, that means R plus R upon IR is equal to L1 by L2. This gets cancelled out. A is to find out internal resistance, R only. Therefore, rearranging the term, and we get R upon R is equal to L1 by L2 minus 1. Here is R. R upon R is 1 plus 1 on this side minus 1. Again, rearrangement, R can be written as L1 by L2 minus 1 into R. That means R can be written as L1 minus L2 upon L2. In this way, we can determine internal resistance of a cell in terms of ohm. L1 is the balancing length when this resistance works not in a circuit. That time, we have to determine the balancing length L1, that value is constant. Then, by changing the resistances, determine the different values of L2 and find out the internal resistances for different values of L2, and then take its average, and that gives us internal resistance of a cell. For this potentiometer, take a precaution that A point should always be connected to a positive potential. That means source of electricity is connected to the higher potential, is connected to the point A as compared to the B. And another precaution is that the EMF of this cell, it is greater, it should be always greater than 4 volt. That means near to the 6 volt, we have to apply their source of electricity so as to find out better readings. In this way, there are two applications. applications of potentiometer. First one is to compare the EMF of cell. Another one is to determine the internal resistance of a cell.